Now that we have not only our base equipment template, but also our equipment specific templates, we should go ahead and use these new templates to build out blower, chiller, and heater elements for each zone. So I'll start by going back to the elements. We'll do this for zone 1, and then we'll see how we can use the pie builder tool in Excel to quickly build out the same elements for zone 2 and zone 3. So starting with zone 1, I'll right click, select new and new child element. And you'll see here we need to specify which template we want to use, and I'd like to use the blower template. You'll see immediately my new blower element gets built with all the attributes from not only the base equipment template, but also the blower specific template. And it comes in with the naming convention we specified, BLR dash. I'll add the 01 since we're in zone 1. I'll go ahead and check this in. So now we've got our blower for zone 1 built out. Let's go ahead and do the same. Do a new child element. Get a chiller. Check it in and refresh. Oh. Again, we need to specify our full name here. Check that in. Now we'll jump to the attributes and refresh, and everything's fine. So finally, we'll build our new heater. And specify our name. And check in and refresh. And looks like everything's fine for our heater as well. Now that we have our three equipment elements for zone 1, we'll see how we can take these three existing elements and use them with the pie builder tool in Excel to build out a similar set of elements for zone 2 and zone 3. So first we'll want to switch over to Excel, and I'll just open up a new workbook, and we'll get to our pie builder tab. The first thing you want to check when you go into the pie builder is make sure that your servers and database are all set correctly. In this case, they are for me. And previously, when we used the builder, we used this library button to go in and find our equipment template and import its configuration so we could add some new attributes to export back to the database. In this case, we're going to be working with the three specific elements that we built, so we'll want to use this elements button to find them. Now you could go and import all elements from your database or use the browse to page down through your hierarchy to find a specific element. But here we want to use the find elements so we get the search dialog. And this works very similarly to the one in PySystem Explorer, it just looks a little bit different. So we'll want to start by specifying a root element to search in. I'll search with zone 1 as my root since the three elements I want appear under that zone. And then I could go into name and do some sort of name search like star dash 01 since I know that all the names end in that. Or I could go into templates, and since I know they're all based off the same parent template of the element template, I can select that and that should turn up all the elements I'm looking for. So there we go, I got my three elements that I'll use equipment template as their base template. And I'll select all three of those and import them. The next thing we're going to have is it's going to ask me which columns I want in the spreadsheet. And we have our required columns that give us the selected so we know what to export. And also the parent of the element, the name of the element, and the object type, which in this case will be element. And then there's a bunch of default boxes checked under element. We can clear those out by clicking twice on this element checkbox. And then really the only one we need is the template name that the element uses. Going further down, we see there's some extended properties. We don't need that. We don't want to import specific attributes as rows, so we'll go ahead and uncheck all the attribute boxes. We're not going to worry about analyses here or ports. What we will want to do is import attributes as columns. So here, since we are starting with one of our templates. It's showing me everything under the blower template. And all of our table lookup data references can use the same format that they've been using, so we don't need to make any adjustments to the configuration string for those. What we want to do is grab all the attributes that use a py tag, though, because we know we need to specify the correct py tag for each attribute. So those would be fan speed, power, vibration frequency, and status. And we'll go ahead and uncheck these other two that we don't need. And finally, we have all the columns we want to specify. We can just hit OK, and everything gets imported. So here you'll see we have the parent is zone 1. Here are my element names that we've built. The object type is element, and it tells us which template those elements are built off of. So all those fields will be key when we want to build new elements from the spreadsheet. And the next thing you'll notice is we have these other columns. These have attribute names as the column header. The way I know they're attribute names is because of this pipe symbol in front of the attribute name. And then we'll see some particular syntax here for the builder. You'll see that there's an equal sign in front of each of these tag names. And this is so that the AF Builder knows to interpret any string that comes after the equal sign as being something that should be plugged into the configuration string for the attribute rather than the value of the attribute. So if I just put something like 34 here, it would go in and it would plug in 34 as the attribute value. But since we want to actually change the configuration string by adding a new tag for the PyPoint data reference, we need to have an equal sign beforehand. Now the other thing you'll notice is that because Excel will interpret a leading equal sign as the beginning of a formula, an Excel formula, we need to have this single quotation mark in front as well. And that's just going to tell Excel to leave this text alone and not try to interpret it as an Excel formula. Now before we move on to building our Zone 2 and Zone 3 elements, I want to make sure everything is okay with the Zone 1 elements. And you can see here that these power tags are all the same for all three pieces of equipment, and the same for the status. And that's because when we built that base equipment template, just as a quick and easy way to finish that process, we selected the tag for the Zone 1 blower. But in reality, if you remember from our tag naming convention, if I jump back to our HVAC system presentation, we saw that there's this code here and that each of the letters in the code indicate what type of tag is being used, and the three-digit numerical code, the first digit is going to indicate our zone locations and the second digit is going to indicate our equipment type. So here these are all zone 1 equipments, so the first digit is fine, it's a 1. But we need to update the second digit for the chiller and the heater. From our tag naming convention, we know that the chiller uses a numerical code of 2. So if we just do a Control H, which is a find and replace, we can easily just change that 11 to a 12. And that changes that second digit to a 2. So I'll just replace all those. And then for the heater, we'll do the same thing, but we'll change from 11 to 13. Replace all those. And now we can see that our chiller is using a J120 tag, and our heater is using a J130 tag. So we have the proper numbering scheme for our chiller and heater tags in zone 1. So now that everything is squared away with our zone 1 elements, let's go ahead and copy everything in these rows, and then we'll paste it one time to make our zone 2 elements, and a second time to make our zone 3 elements. So here, all this equipment should be in zone 2, so everywhere we have a 1, we need it to be a 2. The same is true for all of these tag names. This first row is a little tricky because there's two 1s in there since the blower number is a 1. So I'll go ahead and do these tags first. since they're kind of the exception to the rule. And again, we'll do Control-H, and in this case, we'd want to convert everywhere we see an 11 to a 21. So that's going to change the zone number only, which is the first digit, but leave the second digit, which is 1 for the blower, intact. So we'll go ahead and do a replace all there. And then I'll do the same for the blowers in zone 3. So we'll change from 11 to 31. Place all. And then we'll go ahead and fix everything in zone 2 that needs to be changed. And for those, we're going to change anywhere we see a 1 to a 2. Place all. And then we'll do the same thing for these zone 3 elements. Get my tag names here. Everywhere we see a 1, we want to change to a 3. So we change from zone 1 to zone 3. Do a replace all. And let's check that everything looks okay here. So we have zone 2. We have the correct element names for each zone. And then for our tags, we have the corresponding numbers. Everything starts with a 2 here. And for the equipment, we have 1 for blower, 2 for chiller, 3 for heater. 1 for blower, 2 for chiller, 3 for heater. So everything looks okay with our tags now. And we can go ahead and export this. So I'll hit publish. In this case, we want to do create and edit modes because we're going to edit these zone 1 elements where we updated the pie tag information. And we want to create all of our zone 2 elements here and zone 3 elements. So go ahead and hit OK. Runs through those pretty quickly and it says it's complete with no errors. If we go back to Pi System Explorer and do a refresh, now we see that we have elements for all of our equipment under Zone 2 and Zone 3. And we can see here that, say, for the status of the heater in Zone 3, using the Y330 tag, which is correct, Y being for the status tag, the first 3 being for the zone, Zone 3, and the second 3 being for the heater. So you can see how you can use this Pi Builder tool to very quickly expand your hierarchy. You know, if we had been wanting to build out, say, 5 or 10 zones, it would be much faster to go through this Pi Builder tool than it would be to try and build them one by one. Also, since we were updating a lot of attributes and changing their configuration strings, you can see how the Pi Builder tool is also very handy for that. I wanted to go ahead and show you that instead of using the better way, which would be substitution parameters, because I realize that not all systems will have a nice tag naming convention like this with a convenient pattern for every tag in the system. So it's good to know how we can very quickly import a whole lot of elements to the Pi Builder and get all the configuration strings for their attributes so that we can easily map tags to these attributes. And if you wanted a convenient way to get tag names in the right format, if you have Pi Data Link, you could just go to the search, and here I've already done a search. I know that all my HVAC tags have HVAC in the descriptor. The way I did that, I just typed star, HVAC star, oops. Hit the search. Turns up all my HVAC tags. I could do a Control-A to grab all those and hit OK. And you can see that they're already in this convenient format with the //server name/tag name. That needs to be used when configuring these configuration strings. And if you wanted to take it a step further, you could use Excel's concatenate function. And you could even do a double quote, single quote, equal sign, double quote. And then the next string is going to be the tag name from the cell reference. Close the parentheses and hit OK. And now it can even get the full format with the single quote and equal sign in front. to use for any of my tags that I might want to come and plug in for these attributes over here. So now you have a tool that can make it much easier when you need to map pie tag names to attributes in AF, because understandably not all systems will be conveniently set up to use substitution parameters easily. And I know it can be a tedious task to do this tag mapping, but if you consider the benefits of having a full AF structure built out, especially if you take our next class and you start seeing how you can add analyses and notifications and event frames and templatize everything to make it really easy to build all that structure out, the upfront time investment to build your AF structure with the correct tag mappings is really minor compared to the long-term benefit. So next we'll go through and see how we could have used substitution parameters to easily build these tag names through the template itself, and how if we make a change to a template and we have elements that need to be reverted back to the template, we can do that quickly in bulk through the PyBuilder tool.